Hello everyone, this is Srikant Renla, so from the InfoSec train. So in today's concept, we'll be discussing about cyber threats to the mobile devices. So what are the cyber threats are possible to the mobile devices and what are the cyber threats we have, we'll be discussing in today's session. So coming to the today's our agenda. Yes. First, what is mobile and what are the mobile devices we have? And whenever we are talking about the security threats of the mobile devices, first we need to know the importance of the mobile devices. Yes. Next, we will be discussing about the different types of mobile security threats and different types of countermeasures we need to take. And conclusion, and we'll be ending our session with our conclusion. Yes. First, what is mobile? Coming to the word mobile is, which is movable. So we can easily move from one place to the another. So the word mobile means which is movable. Let's take an example of the mobile. So like mobile canteen, mobile ATM, like this. So willing to move easily from one place to the another or freely between the two places. We can say that is mobile. Yes. So what are the mobile devices we have? A piece of portable electronic equipment then connect to the internet, especially smartphone or tablet or computer. So a piece of portable electronic equipment, we can say that mobile devices which we can connect to the internet. And different types of mobile devices, we have smartphones, we have laptops and computers and etc. So these are the main different types of mobile devices. And so whenever we are talking about the security threats, first we need to know importance of the mobile devices. First, what is we can use the mobile devices, the best use of the mobile devices is communication. Mobile devices has developed for the first the communication purpose, and we can communicate anyone in the world, right, by using the mobile devices. And these mobile devices are smaller and convenient. We can use it very simply. And we have and we can use the photos and videos, and we can use as texting purpose and entertainment purpose. And we can also use the navigation purpose. Also, we can use the mobile devices and online banking and finance purpose. Also, we can use it. And remote working also, every day the employees will be working from the work from home, right? We can also use remote working and emergencies purpose and crime prevention and evidence gathering purpose. And the last one is learning and research purpose. Also, we can use the mobile devices. So these are the main importance of the mobile devices. Yes, when coming to the types of mobile security threats, we have four types of mobile security threats: mobile application security threats, web-based mobile security threats, mobile network security threats, mobile device security threats. So we'll discuss one by one what are the threats we have or we'll be discussing over here. First, when coming to the mobile network security threats, we can say that the network is an heart of mobile attacks. Almost every organization is experienced at least one mobile malware attack in 2020. So you can look at the diagram over here. These are the attacks that happened in 2020. So 93% of the attacks originated in the device network itself. And when coming to the mobile application security threats, everyone is using the applications in their mobile phones, right? So it means everyone is at risk. So 46% of organizations have at least one employee to download a malicious mobile application that threatened networks and data. Yes, when coming to the mobile application security threats, we have most damaging threats associated with the app downloads in 2020. One is GMOB malware, one is EventBot. So what is this GMOB malware? What is this GMOB malware and what is this EventBot? GBump malware is a new Android malware strain. GBump is mimicking third-party mobile apps to spy and steal user data when downloaded and installed. This Trojan virus steals data from users, primarily targeting the online banking and cryptocurrency. This GBump malware targeting the banking and cryptocurrency. And how this GBump malware works? GBump malware works by sitting in a mobile device and searching for banking apps. Then it opens a door for threat actor to steal money while another app is running as a cover. The GBump group will use emails or malicious sites to redirect users' website promoting Android apps. What this GBump group will do, the email is usually sent to the users with a link. This link takes the users to an authenticate looking app, mostly provided by a fraudulent creditor. This GBump Trojan malware installs itself and then sends a message back to the command and control server containing victims' phone data, like including the what kind of mobile it is and what kind of model the mobile is having, and screen lock details, and steals sensitive information from the user. And we have event bot. So what is a new type of Android malware named as event bot, which was first identified in March 2020. This malware appears to be newly developed, with the code differs significantly from the previously known Android malware. So event bot is under active development and is evolving rapidly. New versions are released every few days with improvements and capabilities. And when coming to the mobile application security threats, so we have top 5 2020 mobile malwares, Hidad and Hex Helper, Necro Preempo, and Gorilla. And first coming to the Hidad, what is this Hidad? Is it one of the malware family use advertising the main monetization method? This malware uses different methods to display as many ads as possible to the users, including by installing a new hidden adware. By taking advantage of super user rights, the malware can hide in the system folder and making it very difficult to delete. And coming to the X Helper, he is among the family of Trojan droppers that delivers malware on a mobile devices. It quickly infected over 45,000 devices during a 6 months of period in 2019. The number since then has continued to rise by the hundreds of daily, with this malware still showing up strong in 2020 also. So one of the X-Helper is its resistance up to any form of detection and deletion. So users can perform factory resets and the malware soon shows again and continues to thrive on their mobile devices. So if you reset your mobile phone also, it will be existing in your mobile devices. The malware sits silently on the devices and waits for the commands from the attackers. It also modifies a system library. It is also modified the system library intending to prevent infected users from remounting system partitions in the write mode. And we have Necro, we have Preempo, Gorilla. These are the mobile application security threats in 2020. And mobile application security threats, we have popular app vulnerabilities. Major vulnerabilities in 2020 are found in the major social media sites, Facebook, Instagram, and we have WhatsApp. So these are the vulnerabilities are found in the Facebook also. So what happened in the Facebook in 2020? So in November 2020, a Facebook Messenger vulnerability was discovered through the company's bug bounty program. So the company has conducted bug bounty program. In the bug bounty program, they have found that these vulnerability. So what is this vulnerability exactly? It has and it allowed a hacker to call the user and listen them on their device, and even if the call was not answered. Suppose I am calling to you through a messenger, even you have not lifted the call also, I can listen your communication. So whatever you are talking. So how scary it is. Yes. So when coming to the Instagram, in September 2020, we have found vulnerability in Instagram that could have been used to perform remote code execution on victim's phone. And in WhatsApp also, we have some vulnerabilities which will lead to the cause to the app crash and lose the data. And mobile application security threats, and not only an applications, and the attacks are happening on the Google Play Core also. It is an interface. Google Play Core library is an app's runtime interface. Even attacks has happened in Google Play Core also. And so, and mobile device security threats, vulnerability, we can say that device is vulnerability by nature itself, right? The fact that at least 45% of the world's mobile devices are inherently vulnerable to these cyber attacks. Vulnerabilities are not exclusive to the operating systems of the mobile device, but it can also inherent to the actual hardware also. So whenever talking about the threats to the mobile devices, attacks can happen on the, we can find the vulnerabilities based on the operating systems also. So it is not limited to the operating systems. It is also chances of attacks on the hardware also. So the impact of hardware vulnerabilities, when we are talking about the Qualcomm DSP chip damage, it can bring the following impact. Attackers can leak the information. Attacker can render the mobile phone unresponsive. And attack and malware and other malicious codes. So these are the attacks can happen on the mobile device security threats. On the when the hardware has got vulnerable, there is a chance of attacks. So attackers can leak the information over here, including the photos, videos, and like call recordings, real-time microphone data, GPS, and location data, and more without any user interaction required. So, and attackers can render the mobile phone unresponsive. It means where the owner would have to factory reset the device, causing the entire contents to be permanently deleted. And malware and other malicious code. It means it can completely hide their activities and render them unremovable. Once it is infected and we cannot find it and we cannot remove over here. And mobile device security threats, the impact of OS vulnerabilities. The impact of OS vulnerabilities. Yes, when coming to the impact of OS vulnerabilities, there is a in Android in 2020, multiple vulnerabilities were discovered in Android. The most severe, which can enable remote code execution with the context of privileged access, privileged process. So this vulnerability enables an attacker to install programs and view, change, or delete data and create new accounts with full user rights. And one more vulnerability is StrandHub. So is another, we can say that by using this vulnerability that allows hackers to gain access to the almost any app. And when we are talking about the iOS, the major vulnerabilities are discovered in iOS in 2020, a sign-in with Apple bug and a zero-click vulnerability and LightSpy. A sign-in with Apple bug that left any account exposed to hijack or attack, and a zero-click vulnerability that enables threat actors with remote code execution and infection capabilities via sending emails and consumes a lot of memory. And LightSpy is a modular malware that exploits a remote code execution vulnerability in the Safari browser. This malware grabs data from the iOS keychain. We will be using the iPhones, right? In iOS, we have by default the browser is Safari. So what it will do, this malware grabs the data from the iOS keychain. In iPhone, we have keychain setting is there. In keychain, we'll be handling the credentials that are stored on the device, right? So that are stored on the devices. So that will grab the credentials from the keychain itself. That is a LightSpy vulnerability. And when you're talking about the MDM is a powerful new attack vector. During 2020 event with the significant, that is the pre-reaching, namely for the first time corporate MDM was used as an attack vector. Because why it is has treated as a powerful attack vector, a single central control for the entire mobile network is also it's a major weakness, right? So it has introduced a robust malware variant infected over 75% of the company's devices via corporate-owned mobile device manager. So MDM treated as a powerful new attack vector. So what this Cerberus malware will do, Cerberus malware is very damaging. For once it is installed, it can collect a large amount of sensitive data, including user credentials, and send it to a remote command and control servers. And when coming to the web-based mobile security threats, web-based threats tend to go and unnoticed. They happen when people are visit affected sites. Suppose if you have visited any affected site, automatically it will download some malicious files into your systems and we cannot recognize it. So because we will be using the high speed internets, the malwares will be 1 KB, 2 KB, 3 KB, 4 KB. The size will be in that list only, right? So when you visit a particular malicious website, automatically it will download and we cannot recognize that kind of malwares also. And common examples of mobile security threats. So data leakage via malicious apps. When you have downloaded malicious apps, there is a chance of data leakage. And unsecured public Wi-Fi. So whenever you're connecting to any public Wi-Fi, means it will be open network, right? The attackers will keep the network open and we make them to connect, right? So we should not use the public Wi-Fi network. And spywares and poor password habits. Whenever you're keeping the password, we will be keeping the poor passwords, right? So these are the common examples. Keeping the poor passwords also is one of the security threat, and loss or stolen mobile devices. So out of date operating systems. So this is also one of the major security threats. So we need to update with our operating system. So whenever the vendor has released an update, so we need to update as per the rules. And these are the countermeasures we need to take. We need to ensure the mobile security and privacy. We need to always password protect your phone. We need to always password protect your phone. And we need to download only the applications from the safe apps. We need to download only safe apps. And always read the terms and privacy policy. And always turn off Bluetooth. So whenever it is required, you can turn it on. But we should not keep it turned on the entire day, and we need to make it turn off. And we need to encrypt the phone and set up remote locate or wipe. It means whenever you lost your mobile, we can remotely wipe our data. So we can backup our data. We need to take the backup data and don't jailbreak or root your phone. So if you do jailbreak and root your phone, the entire security has gone and you don't get any warranty also. and update the operating systems. We need to update the operating system as per the vendor releases and download the anti-malwares. We need to download the anti-malwares in order to protect our data and use public Wi-Fi with a caution. So we need to use the public Wi-Fi with a caution, and we need to use the VPN. And take steps to protect your mobile phones. When you're choosing a mobile phone, when you're going to buy a mobile phone, consider its security features. We need to go through the security features. And whenever you're configuring the device, configuring the device to be more secure. In secure way, we need to configure our mobile devices and configure web accounts. Configuring the devices more secure, configure web accounts to use secure connections. Don't follow links sent in a suspicious email or text messages. So every day we will be getting the short URLs in our text message, right? Don't click on any links and limit exposure of our mobile phone number. Whenever you are giving mobile number on the social media, on the internet, so we need to limit that mobile number. We should not give anywhere our mobile number. So carefully consider what information you want to store on the device. It will be very careful while giving the and selecting the apps, while giving the information. And be wise when selecting and installing the apps from the store. Disable interfaces that are currently currently in use, such as Bluetooth or Wi-Fi. So do not boot or jailbreak your devices. If you do that, your security will go. And act quickly if your mobile phone is stolen. Suppose if your mobile phone has stolen, first you need to report the loss of your organization and mobile service providers, and report the loss of theft to the local authorities like police departments and police stations. And immediately you can change your account credentials if necessary. If there is an option, you can wipe out your phone data also. And when coming to the conclusion, so every day these are the attacks that happen to the mobile devices. So addressing the mobile protection needs and developing the mobile threat defense solutions is very important in these days. So these threat defense solutions will prevent the malicious app downloads, and we need to prevent the phishing across all the apps, preventing man-in-the-middle attacks, blocking infected devices from the accessing corporate apps, and detecting advanced jailbreaking and routing techniques and voice exploits. Thank you.